Closing of Borders bookstores is giving smaller, independent booksellers an opportunity for growth and change. And here to talk about that is Gayle Shanks, founder and co-owner of Changing Hands Bookstore in Tempe. Always good to see you. Thanks for joining us. The impact of Borders closing on your store.
You know, we don't know yet. It's just happened, you know, in the last couple of months. But what we're finding is that already a lot of the Borders customers who no longer have a neighborhood bookstore are coming to our store. And we're very excited about that. We've felt since Borders started opening in the 90s, one store after the next, that it was way too much bookselling retail space for the number of readers in the valley. Mm-hmm. And so we were kind of waiting to see, was it going to be Barnes & Noble that was going to be the king of the mountain, or was it going to be Borders that was the king of the mountain? And, you know, curiously enough, it's now Barnes & Noble and Borders is gone, but we think that the balance is now going to shift to the place where there is the right amount of bookstores for the number of people and the number of readers, and we're very excited about it.
The market will adjust, in other words.
It's adjusting. It is adjusting.
You, Changing Hands, for a long time Valley resident, Changing Hands was an institution on Mill Avenue. Mm-hmm. And it seemed as though Borders, and I don't know, maybe you know more about this than you maybe want to tell us, but it seemed as though Borders targeted your store and may have targeted other independent bookstores in trying to find a place to do business. Ran you guys out of Mill Avenue. I mean, is that somewhat accurate there?
It's pretty close to accurate. Borders did that all over the country. And, you know, you talk about karma, and it's kind of like, okay, you tried this, it didn't work, and Changing Hands is still around. But we were negotiating for the exact same space that Borders actually moved into on Mill Avenue. And, you know, we just couldn't get the deal that the landlord was willing to give to the Borders. And so we decided, that was when we decided to open our second store on McClintock and Guadalupe.
Which is doing very well.
It's doing very well.
How is it doing well in a time of e-readers, in a time of Amazon online, the whole nine yards? How are you guys surviving? How are you guys flourishing?
Well, we are surviving and we are flourishing. And we're very excited about that. We feel like bookselling is more than just the physical book. We know that people can buy books anywhere. What we give people when they come into our store is an environment, a place to relax, a place to talk about books with passionate booksellers, a place to find the next thing they want to read, a place to bring their children to teach their kids about books, and a place to meet authors. And we have found over the years that providing that kind of third place is what people come to us for at the same time they're coming to us for books. So it's a dual thing. You can buy a book on Amazon, but it's just a book. When you come to Changing Hands, you buy a book, but you have a conversation, you have some kind of connection with someone that's in the same aisle looking at books along, you know, with you. You have a chance to talk to an author who's there. So it's the experience more than it is the actual book that you've come in to look for.
How did, and perhaps continues to do so, the impact of e-readers, the impact of online, the Amazons of the world, how much of an impact has that made, and how much has that made you have to change what you do?
You know, we change every day. You know, my byword at this moment is mutate. I just feel like I wake up in the morning and I think, okay, we have to evolve, we have to mutate into something else. Ebooks forced us one more time to look at what we were doing and how we were doing it and how we were going to deal with people reading more on their readers. But, you know, 64 million Americans read at least 5 hours a week. That's a lot of people reading, and it's good if they're reading on their e-readers because they're reading. It's better for a bookstore like mine if they're reading with a physical book, or if they buy an ebook from us. You know, independent bookstores in this country can now sell Google ebooks, and we are selling Google ebooks, and the only thing we can't sell an ebook, the only device we can't sell it for, is an Amazon Kindle. Every other device you can buy a book at Changing Hands the same way you can buy a book off our shelves, you can buy a book off our website.
Does the demise of Borders suggest that secondhand bookstores, you sell new and used, started off only as used only,
right,
though? Will we see more of these little mom and pop things popping up here and there, used only bookstores? Because, you know, as you say, you can get an iPad, you can get a Kindle, mm-hmm, and never touch a book for the rest of your life. Mm-hmm. But those who do like to pass them on, there could be a market there.
That's right. And I think there are many, many, many used bookstores in the country that are flourishing right now. And, you know, Changing Hands started, as you say, as a used bookstore. We love our used books. We love the idea that people can come in and recycle their books. They get credit. They can buy a new book. They can buy a used book. They can buy, you know, a Solari Bell in the store with their credit. And we love that idea of recycling. We started out in the 70s thinking about alternative living and sustainability, and lo and behold, here we are in 2011, and people are talking about sustainability and ecology and recycling. And so we've never lost our love for used books, and I think there's lots of stores in the country that are going to thrive on being able to recycle those books as well.
You mentioned the Solari Bells. You sell games and toys, and mm-hmm, you sell back to schools. It's more than just a bookstore. When does a bookstore threaten to become something different? Because when you started, I remember your store in Mill Avenue. It was a bookstore.
It was really a bookstore.
It was books and maybe some cards here and there, mm-hmm, but books. Mm-hmm. This, your store now, you got a lot of things in there. When is that other stuff too much and you lose that bookstore ambiance and character?
I hope never. You know, one thing that the gifts and the sidelines that we carry does, they allow us to keep all of those books that we love on our shelves, because the profit in some of the gift items is higher than the profit is in books. So it's kind of this fine balance that we walk. We love the idea that Changing Hands can be a one-stop shopping experience for people. So we're always trying to come up with new things that they can see when they come in the store that will become an impulse or a gift. And, you know, you have a birthday. Just about everybody has a birthday just about every day that they need to buy a present for. And sometimes if you don't know if someone's a reader, you often know that they like a certain kind of lotion or, you know, a toy if it's a child. And that's one area that we've really expanded dramatically, our kids' books and our kids' toys. And we're encouraging parents to come and buy birthday presents, for instance, on the weekends when they go to these birthday parties, buy them at Changing Hands as opposed to one of the big box stores.
Last question before you go. For those who say bookstores will soon be a rarity, like record stores and other things that you can get online, that eventually they're just going to go the way of the dinosaur, how do you respond?
I want to tell you that I think there have been bookstores for 5,000 years and there's going to be bookstores for another 5,000. I think books are icons of our culture. They really hold all of the information that we have as a culture inside in those words. And I think words are crucial to us as a society. Sharing those words are part of who we are as human beings. I don't think they're ever going to go away.
Gayle, it's good to see you. Thanks for joining us.
It's really nice to see you, too. Thank you.